Hi, my name's Norman Beaumont. I'm a product consultant at Intelledox, and today I'll be taking you through the quick start guide. But before we do that, I'll take you through a little bit of an overview. And in this overview, I'll basically just show you the three applications within Infiniti, those being produce, manage, and design. Starting off with produce, as you can see, it's a web-based application. So all you and your end users need to access this is an internet browser. Once you've clicked to access the site, depending on what groups have been assigned to your user profile, determines what projects you'll be able to see on this homepage. Clicking on any one of these links will open up the associated web form. So for instance, if I click on the employment contract, that will redirect me to the associated web form, so it'll open up the employment contract and the associated questions for this web form. Depending on the questions that I've used while building my project within design, determines what the end user will actually see within this web form. And also, at the time of building, you'll click and drag any of your business rules onto each question, and it will dynamically show and hide the questions in relation to the conditions that you've applied. In here, it will contain conditional questions, so we can dynamically load questions relevant to the end user's answers that they've provided within the web form. It will also ask for mandatory details, so the user must adhere to any validation that we've applied, such as mandatory fields and simple validation or complex validation against any one of these fields. So for instance, a first name must be a maximum of 50 characters. Once the user has adhered to any validation and filled out all of their questions, they can cycle through the web form and fill out any details. As you can see, we've got a date picker up on the screen here. So it can provide nice controls to the end user to collect the relevant information for our output. Submitting the application will trigger off any actions and also generate any output that we've previously elected during publishing. And if I click to access one of these generated outputs, we can see the information that I've supplied throughout the web form is pushed into the end document, into key locations that we've specified previously. So now that I've shown you a little bit about Produce, let's go over to the administrator side and have a look at both manage and design. Next, we have Manage. This is what your administrators will have access to, and they will be managing their projects, users, resources, and performing their general administration tasks, such as changing settings and looking at reports. But I won't get too much into the manage or the administration side of things. What we're here for is this guy, Design, at the top right-hand corner. To open up Design, you first off need to make sure that you're in Manage. Then you can tell up the top left-hand corner it's got a nice Manage logo. If you're in Produce, and you can see this screen, at the top right-hand corner you can click on Manage, and that will actually cycle you between both applications. So don't need to move the mouse too far. So when we're in Manage, click to open up Design up the top right-hand corner. That will download a temporary application to your local called Design. To actually get this guy installed on your local machine, you must make sure that you have .NET 4 installed on your local. You'll see that we've got tasks up the top left-hand corner here, recent projects, and Intelledox news. It's our latest and greatest of what we're currently doing and achieving at the time. Everything's pretty straightforward, but I'll just go through them. Create new project, open from a file, import a project, and open from a database. This guy obviously lets you make a new project, and this guy opens something that you've previously created. These two in the middle here are generally used for importing and exporting projects from one environment to another. But to get started, we'll click on Open from Database, then our Getting Started project. And once you've opened up our Getting Started project, you'll see we've started off in our question set with New Page 1 and Finish. Over the left-hand side, you'll see we've got our toolbox. This is where we're going to be adding things such as our layout options and questions into our question set. And on the right-hand side is basically our properties section. This will load to whatever we've selected within our question set. So really, in essence, the middle guy here is our project. So it will show you what questions we've applied within our question set, our layout options, and any particular delivery methods, such as actions, that we've assigned to be triggered on our finish date. But before we get into creating our question set, we need to make sure that our output is going to be right first. So we'll click to open our Word tool up the top. Once you've opened up the Word document, and I mean, this is something that we've already supplied for you. Generally, you would go through and select your own document to upload, but for this tutorial, we've supplied our best books exercise, where we're going to insert data from a web form into specific locations within the end document. So that data is going to be a date, so today's date, the customer's name, and the number of days we're going to provide the customer with a discount. So once we've got our specific location, so we've made our nice template that we're going to use consistently each and every time, we need to specify locations within the document that we're going to manipulate within the Infiniti web form. So in this case, we're going to insert data into specific locations. And to do so, we need to obviously apply placeholders into each location. Now, these placeholders can be insertion placeholders, or they can be selection placeholders. Insertion placeholders specifying a specific location within the document that we're going to be inserting data into. So for instance, our date. And to specify that location, we need to put in two open curly brackets, which is next to the letter P on your keyboard at the very start of the location, and then at the end of the specific location, your closing curly brackets. Noting at this point that I have my paragraph markers turned on, which is this guy up here. I generally find that this helps me out quite a lot when marking up my end document, as you know where your returns end if you've got any spaces within your placeholder name. Then after we've saved, I generally go over to my placeholders tab. This is where we can see the document that's attached to this project and any document fragments. But if I click on the drop down here, I'll see all of the placeholders that I initially created. Now we could actually pull this information from a few different areas, such as data sources. We might pull our customer's name from a CRM, but in this scenario I'll be showing you the user prompt, which is basically just a text box. We're going to publish this to a web form, allow the user to fill out the details to supply the data that we're going to insert into our placeholders. So now we've got our placeholders on the right hand side there. We're going to specify where we're going to pull the information from. I just said that's going to be the user prompt. So if I want to add a user prompt into my project, I simply just need to click and drag a user prompt from my left hand side toolbox and drop it on top of new page one within the question set. Notice how that guy gets added on new page one. with specific defaults that we can change. So we've got new page one there, new question one, and our new answer, which we can change to what we like. And that is our date. So we'll ask the user for our date, click into the user prompt, and we'll change our question text. Notice, remember that the properties changes to what you have selected within your question set. If I want to change this guy, I'll change the question text to the data that I'm after. So what is today's date? Again, you wouldn't really ask the end user for this. We could use an inbuilt formula by clicking and dragging a variable over and then defining the date. It's that simple. But this is really just getting you used to the basic functionality of Infiniti. So we've changed our question. Oh, I might just go back and change the new page one as well. We'll call this best books. Then within our question, we've got our what is today's date. Now the important part here is the data type. So clicking on our user prompt. This is how we're going to actually treat the data that the end user is inserting. And also, depending on the data type that we select here, it will also apply a simple validation. So making sure that the end user is inserting a correct date. We select date because that's what we're after. Now that I've got my question set up, I'll click down into my answer. Now you can generally leave these answers as default, but that is primarily bad practice. We here at Intelledox like to name our answers so they can be referred to at later points if we ever need to do answer referencing. So we'll call this today's date. And in our answer, we can also select how we want our input, which is our question, to be formatted. So in this case, it's a date. So we'll select short date from here. Now obviously we've got our properties set up, so we've got our page, our question, our answer, so where we're getting our input from, and how we're going to format our output. Now where are we going to place our output? That is our placeholder's job. So we define where it's going into our Word document by assigning our placeholder. So to assign a placeholder, it's pretty much just like how easy it was clicking and dragging our user prompt and dropping it on our page. We literally just click into our placeholders tab, click and drag our date placeholder, and drop it on top of our answer. Now we know where our input is going to go. So I'm just going to quickly go and add in another couple of user prompts. Notice how I'm double clicking. We also allow the end user to double click. And double checking what I need over here, I can click define number of discounted days and customer name. See there, I just really just hit F2 so I could rename those. It's totally up to you how you really want to edit this tree view in here. Again, obviously one thing that I've forgotten is assigning my placeholders, otherwise my data won't know where to go. And renaming our answers, discounted days, customer name. Can format these as well. So customer name, we might select proper case for that guy, and this guy can be general number. So once we've defined the questions, we'll need to save our project and publish from within our manage tool before we can actually see it in produce. So if I was to click into produce now, I cannot see that project until I publish my project into Produce into a particular folder. So I need to click into folders, make sure I've got a folder to publish to. And if I don't, I'll click New Folder and I'll call this Norms Demo. These are the groups that can actually see projects published to Norms Demo. I'll just go ahead and save that. Your changes have been saved. If I click back into folders now, I'll see Norms Demo here with no projects in here. Now, for me to publish a project to this folder, I need to click over into Projects. Find my project name in here, and if you have quite a lot of projects in your database, you can actually search by name. For me, I've just got Getting Started. I'll click on that. There's heaps of buttons here, but the one we're after is Publish. Now, when you're publishing, this is where you define the publishing options for that particular project. So these publishing options are what formats we're going to generate. You can see we've got quite a few there. Presentation formats, spreadsheets, messages along the way to help out the user, and different publishing options. And you can have a look at those throughout your own tests. The one we're after really is the top guy, our folder. You click on the ellipse to the right of the folder and you'll get a pop-up. Click on the folder that you wish to publish the project to. So you'll see that Norms Demo has gone into our folder. We'll save. And now when clicking into Produce, I can see the project that I have created. And again, clicking through. Now, depending on, obviously, you can see what questions we've used determines what the user will see in our web form. Now that we've generated our document, I'll be able to open it up and you'll see that the locations that we've specified within our design tool have now been populated by the input from the user prompts that we defined while building.